Agilent SLIMS version 6.7 covers a lot of ground for stability study testing of products, rules, automatically aggregated results, and ease of use. However, this video will concentrate on the enhancements related to the stability study modules. We'll break it down into these highlights: use a stability study template, create a stability study, enroll stability batches, pooling and measuring orders, operation and getting results, and stability study reports. Stability studies are created based on a configured version of a stability study template in your SLIMS. After the first template is designed, templates for similar products can be quickly created by copying the original and choosing a product. Specifications for products can be brought in from the Products and Specifications module. To do so, the product specifications you want are marked as propagated, and the stability study design needs to indicate the version of specifications to reuse. What gets copied? The full template with its root specifications to test, its storage conditions, time points, and the specifications that need to be tested per time point. Any of the scheduled planning for retrieving content from storage and testing are included as designed in the template. Only the version templates with products can become a study. When you create a stability study, you get the full tree with the study details, the configured storage conditions, down to each time point and its associated specifications. We'll examine the module later when we have something to enroll. We need a content type that serves as the batch for a stability study. This could be a content that indicates multiplicity, like a bottle that contains a bunch of pills. In this case, 1500 units track the number of pills as a custom quantity field. The product allows this content to be enrolled in the stability study. The batch is enrolled to trigger the time point enrollments and order creation. First, I'll explain the orders we're using. Pooling orders are how we plan to schedule sample removal from storage, and measuring orders are the scheduled plan for testing. This progress bar shows some orders being created because a measurement order of the chosen QC order type is created for each time point in the orders module. If pulling orders are being used at the pulling workflow, then a pulling order is also created for each time point. We are including pulling orders in this video. No matter what, a batch enrollment is created at every single time point in the study that will track the status, location, derivation, and other information about the enrolled batch. The Batch tab also shows some start and end dates. These come from the stability study's design, and they indicate the earliest allowable date that pulling can start, and latest that pulling must end, earliest allowable date on which measurement can start, and latest date it must be performed by so that the results are valid. They're calculated for each time point separately. The orders view can be modified to add columns, sorting, and grouping to help identify the automatically created stability orders. Without pulling, only these measurement orders would have been created. This order for time point 0 has the batch automatically linked and the request is already added. All the user needs to do is schedule it. The number of samples is relevant if your setup requires a minimum number of pulled contents to come out of the workflow. The setup of the requestable also causes the output to appear on the Fulfillments tab. The batch is scheduled right into the pulling workflow. Using requestables, it could have been sent to this or another standard workflow, or even a particular workflow protocol. Tasks can be automated. Here, this macro splits batches and allocates pulled contents into different locations. This one is aliquoting the right custom quantity into the accelerated testing and long-term storage locations, and the no storage output will be measured for time point 0. Once the requests are finished in the protocol run, the order status changes to completed. The request is also finished now. The Fulfillments tab tracks all the pulled content from the workflow output. In this case, it's several derived contents, but it could also be one output with a bunch of units tracked by a quantity field. In this case, the batch goes into the measurement order for T0, but this is not always true. The technical release notes and admin manual explain exactly how SLIMS determines whether the pulled contents or the original batch gets assigned to the measuring order. In this context, the specifications to be checked are set by the stability study. However, in a normal QC order, they could be set by the product or chosen manually by the user from the version specifications in the contents associated product. Measurement orders have them set automatically, and they cannot be edited to protect the automation, so the order just needs to be scheduled. Default analytical methods can be set to make things easier for the user, or it can be left for them to choose which analytical methods to schedule. Different analytical methods or workflows can be used for various specification testing. The batch or pulled content is queued to the analytical workflow. Changes to rules allow you to create specifications for acceptable limits outside of just numeric data types, including fixed choice, checkboxes, and dynamic choice to reference data. We've added an aggregation method, so a standard deviation or mean can be calculated for each content's results in the protocol step. These pertain only to numeric tests, but aggregate over the multiple automatically created results for each content. A column could be added to the view to see which value is the aggregated one. In this case, three results were automatically created, and we have a standard deviation that calculates over the three values. For these tests, there's one specification rule for the 10 automatically created results to catch outlying values, even if the aggregated value is in range, and a separate specification to check the mean aggregate. Note that these are two distinct specification rules. Once the measurement workflow is done, the QC order changes to completed, and the specification requests are finished. The Result Overview tab shows all the rule evaluations. The stability study has recorded the information related to the enrolled batches. At the study level, the Enrolled Batches tab shows all the enrolled contents and their information. The contents pulled from the batches are in the Pulled Contents tab, but it only shows up if you're using pulling orders. The grid can be customized by modifying a new grid template type and choosing it in the Stability Study template, but that must be done before creating the study from the template version. The Results tab shows all the results for the stability study's measured specification rules. There is also a grid template that can be modified to customize this grid, but it must be done before creating the study from the Stability Study template version. The results can be exported from any level of the study. The workflow icon shows the completed protocol run, or links to it in workflows if the run is still in progress. Reports are configurable and can be adapted to your needs at any level of the study based on report templates. However, a report template is created for every level you want to generate reports for: the study, storage condition, time point, and batch enrollment. You can see the previously generated reports as well. The information in the tabs is filtered so only the relevant information for the selected level is shown. Instead of looking at all enrolled batches, you can click on a time point and see just that time point's pulled contents and results. Thank you for sticking through the whole video to see an example of how stability studies are supported in SLIMS. You can see future tutorials, highlights, and news on our YouTube channel, and check out our website for further product information.